I want to show you a couple things that I learned from a couple German cabinet makers when I was younger on cutting laminate. First of all, most table saw fences have a little bit of a gap underneath them. They're never perfect. And so what happens is, if you're running a piece of laminate, which is very skinny, right up against the fence, what it wants to do is find its way underneath like that, and that makes for a very bad day for everybody. So what Walter did was throw something down on the table saw. I made something for our saw that was just like what he did. It's just this little piece of 1/8 inch aluminum. Okay, it sits right on top of here. Okay, and it tucks under here. So that's how you drop it in. You bring it in, you drop it in, and then you drop it. There's a pin that drops right in here, and it lives right there. So anytime you need it, you pop it out like this, you drop it against your fence, and then there's a hole that corresponds right down here, and that's flush off the back, and that allows your work to sit up on top of it and be guaranteed that it's up against the fence. That's the easiest old school way to do it. There's really no struggle. The other thing is have your blade up so that you have a pretty steep downward angle on the laminate. That's one of the only times that you want to do that. So here's something. Makes it a lot easier to cut. If you have normally when you're cutting most products, you might be most sheet materials, you want to have your blade maybe a 1/2 inch above it so you get a reasonable downward angle. If you have it just above it, you're actually running the risk of kind of chipping out the surface. So there's a sweet spot. But for laminates, it wants to slap around. So you want to have this angle of attack coming down on it. So that's just a Greg Saturday, a little shop tip. Thank you very much.